Good morning. My name is Ivan Williams. I'm the National Sales Manager for Yarcraft Boats, and we're standing out here in the middle of Bull Shoals Lake in a 2014 Yarcraft 209 TFX. This is a 20-foot, 6-inch boat rated up to 300 horsepower. We've got a 300 Verado on it as it's rigged today, running a 23-pitch Tempest prop. I'm going to start in the back of the boat here and kind of give you a walkthrough. In the very back of the boat, over here on this side, we've got a battery storage compartment for your main crank battery. Your Verado power steering unit is in here, and you've got room for a second battery for all your accessories. Panning to the left right here, we've got a new speaker system for the 2014 boats. It's a higher resolution speaker. And right under the steering wheel in front of the console, centered in the consoles, we've got little tweeters right there beside the stereo, which gives you a lot better resolution in your sound. The boat comes standard with 3 seats. The passenger and driver's seats are all air rides. They swivel and have the air ride capacities in them. They adjust up and down. On the side of the boat, we have storage in here for any accessories you want to add. You can also put up to several fishing rods in here. But as you look to the back of the box, we've got rod butt holders in here in order to hold your rods up so your tips will go in. You can put up to about a 7.5 to 8 foot rod down the side and put your rod butts in there to keep them from getting tangled. On the other side of the boat back here, we've got just dry storage on this side over here. You've got a bucket for your minnow, for your bait well, and your minnow bucket, which we'll get to in a few minutes. We've got Perco locks, so you've got all locking storage compartments. Your rear seat is on a standard pedestal. It does swivel. And in the center of the boat back here, you've got up to a 54-inch live well. And it's got 2 different aeration systems. You've got fresh water pump in, and it's got recirculation. Both systems are automatic and manual. You've got lights in your live well, standard equipment. In the very back of the boat back here, you've got an access door. And you've got access to all your switches and pumps. All your plumbing and electrical are all completely accessible right there. You have cartridge style pumps. So if you lose an aerator or a bilge pump, you just pull the cartridge out. You can interchange it with a new one. Even sitting here in the lake, I could put a new cartridge in it and replace the area. You don't have to go to your marina. You don't lose a vacation because you've lost a bilge or an aerator. The console. You've got all your switches and controls right here, very handy. Also new for 2014, we've got a new access door, which is quite a bit larger than the other one. It's monogrammed with a Yarcraft on it. The nice thing about this is you can open it up. For riggers, you can lift the door, take it off, and get it out of your way. Passengers or drivers are always saying, I wish I had more room in the boat. For a person that's a little bit taller, if you wanted to put your feet in here, you can run like this and have plenty of room to stretch out. At the end of the day, you can merely put your lid back on. And you've got another lock here. You can lock it up, keep all your valuables in there, your fishing tackle or whatever valuables you might have, you can keep them stored at night and safe. As we go to the front deck, we have a very nice rod organizer system. This will hold up to an 8 foot, 8.5 foot rod on top and 8 foot on the bottom. You can see an access door underneath. The access door comes out. This is your front battery compartment. You can put up to 3 batteries in here. Your battery charger could fit under the console. Underneath these consoles are big enough you can put your child in there for a storm shelter if you need to. They're very large and very convenient. If you want to clean your fish, you got a nice clean cutting board here. You could even clean your fish and put your cutting board back after you clean it and be done. You've got two big rod actuators on here that hold the lid up even in high winds. It's a big door, but it stays up very conveniently. And to secure your rods, you've got 2 locks on it. Perco locks again. This particular model has a walk-through windshield, or you can get the boat with 2 bubble windshields on it, just for your preference, whichever way you want. You can also add a bimini top or a full enclosure on the boat if you have the walk-through windshield. As you access the front of the boat, as I go up and go to the right, I have a aerated bait well with a minnow bucket in it. Underneath that, if you wanted to keep some perch or some smaller walleye, you could even use this for a smaller live well as well. On the other side, adjacent to that, you have a nice ice chest. It'll hold quite a bit. You have pop-up cleats. There's 2 pop-up cleats in the back of the boat, and we have 2 pop-up cleats up here on the bow of the boat. If you'll pan right back here by the windshield, we've got a gas fill for 53-gallon fuel tank. It's located in the very bottom of the boat and center. It's middle of the boat. Up here in the front, you've also got 2 big storage boxes for tackle, life jackets, or whatever you want. You can also put a butt seat or bring one of your folding chairs up here or add a 5th seat to the boat. In the bow, you're already pre-wired for any electronics you want to put on there. We've got wiring available for electronics to be added easily. You've also got a plug for your trolling motor, your iPilot, or whatever could be mounted up there and ready to plug in and ready to go. You've got 3 courtesy lights up here, 1 in the bow, 1 on each side, and you've got 2 in the back of the boat. This boat comes with 4 seat positions, however, it only has 3 seats standard with it. You can also add 2 more pedestals, and I'm going to be back here and show you. You can add 2 more pedestals, or bases. You can add a base on each side back here. So as you're trolling, you can be back there. It's got a very large cockpit, like when you're putting out your boards and whatever you're wanting to troll. You've got a lot of working room here in the boat. It's a very stable boat. As you see, I'm walking side to side, and we're not getting hardly any movement in the boat whatsoever. Also here in the cockpit, we've got a 12-volt let out over here. We have a 12-volt outlet in the console. You can plug in your cell phones for recharge or plug in spotlights or anything you'd like to do. You've got cup holders up here for your driver and your passenger. And you've got a nice big glove box up here to keep all your things stored. As you see, there's quite a bit in there right now as we speak. There's a big clipboard in here, cleaning supplies. Locks, you got a handle here for your passenger to hang on to. Stereo is conveniently located for your driver to operate. It's an AM/FM CD with Sirius capability and an iPod connection and a CD player. And I believe that pretty well covers it.